It was a bright summer day when Mother called out, "Kids, it's time to get ready to go to Mrs. Karen's house for tea." Mrs. Karen was a dear friend of the family, and Jazy and Zaira loved visiting her place.
"Yay! I can't wait to go see Mrs. Karen. She is so much fun, and I love her big, beautiful house," cried Zaira.
"Me neither," said Jazy.
"Children, I know you enjoy playing in Mrs. Karen's big house, but every time we go, she tends to serve many sweets, jellies, and sugary snacks. I would be pleased if you kids don't eat those sweets anymore, as too much can be very harmful for your health."
All right, Mom,
said Jazy and Zaira. Mrs. Karen was kind and generous as always.
"Come, children, I baked these special jelly cookies just for you. I even made plum candies for you, and there's so much more," said Mrs. Karen.
Immediately, in a rude way, Jazy said,
"Ew, we don't want to eat any of those, they're bad."
"Yes, I don't want any of your sweets either, Mrs. Karen," said Zaira.
Mrs. Karen was surprised, but also deeply hurt. She was sad.
I'm sorry, she said. "I thought you might enjoy it. I made it for you children especially. I'll take them away," said Mrs. Karen.
"Just a second, Mrs. Karen," said Mother. "Children, please come here. I need to speak with you. In life, always remember that whatever you say must be said with humility, respect, and kindness. I asked you not to eat the sweets, but there is a nicer way you can politely say no. Mrs. Karen's feelings have been hurt because of the harsh way you have communicated with her. She loves you and wanted to make you happy. Next time, you can politely say, 'No, thank you.' Or, 'Maybe I'll just have one, thank you.'"
"We're sorry, Mrs. Karen,"
said Jazy and Zaira.
"We didn't mean to hurt you at all. And thank you for always being so kind and letting us play in your home."
"That's all right. I'm glad you children are staying healthy," said Mrs. Karen.
"Run along and play now."
"Yay! Thank you, Mother and Mrs. Karen."